Hello and welcome to our turbine machining days. My name is Jürgen Gläser and today I would like to introduce our Genus M460 to you, which is our smallest 5-axis machining center. This machine is developed based on our MU400. The MU400 is the full 5-axis machine that we can equip with all kinds of options. We can equip it with big magazines, different types of spindles and all other options. Versus the Genus M460 is a package that is ready to go for 5-axis applications. It is a very rigid and stable machine. It has a cast iron bed, a double column construction, and a very strong and proven spindle where we can give 3 years warranty. This 3 years warranty is unlimited without any shift limitation, means you can run the machine either in 1 shift, 2 shifts, or 3 shifts without limits. It is a very productive spindle that is universal. It has a speed range of 50 to 15,000 RPM. It is a 40 taper spindle with 22 kilowatt. The machine is also equipped with our 5-axis SuperNURBS function, which is a function to calculate back from the CAM program to the original surface that was designed in the CAD system. So in the SuperNURBS functionality, we will calculate from the XYZ A and C points back to a spline and execute this as a spline in our axis drives. SuperNURBS also has a functionality where you can apply a tolerance for the machining, means you can do a high speed machining with a bigger tolerance or a high accuracy machining with a smaller tolerance. Also, you can select whether you are roughing, semi-finishing or finishing, which again has an influence on cutting time because it is influencing the acceleration, deceleration directly. The machine is very accurate. We could achieve an accuracy of down to 2 micron in the X, Y and Z axis on an actual machine. This is a measured value. The machine also has our 5-axis auto-tuning system, which I could show you quite shortly on the controller. So the 5-axis auto-tuning system is a very simple method to improve the accuracy of the machine. You just need to place a sphere inside of the machine range and then move the touch probe on top of this sphere. Start this program, which will measure the sphere under different angular positions in the complete working range of the machine. Calculate all geometrical errors like center distance offset or angular errors of rotary axis or of linear axis, and then compensate this in a 5-axis 3D model inside of the controller. By this, the operator can by himself, without using the power of a service engineer, in very short time improve the accuracy of the machine. This is also one of our intelligent technologies. Furthermore, the machine has the latest version of our control, which is the OSP P300MA controller with a 15-inch touchscreen, which makes life very easy for young operators. As they are used to operate smartphones, they will also easily adapt to that controller and they will have no problems to operate it, as it can zoom in, zoom out, like on any kind of smartphone. You can move 3D models around like you are used from your smartphone. Whatever you see is what you are working with. So that means, for example, if I'm switching the focus on the screen, I will directly get the function keys that are belonging to this functionality on the screen. As I mentioned before already, we have equipped this machine as a package with the total simultaneous 5-axis machining kit. In this 5-axis machining kit, we included, for example, the touch probe from Renishaw, which we use for 5-axis auto-tuning, as well as for setting the zero offset or for work compensations or for aligning the workpiece on the rotary table. The machine is equipped with our APSU scale. Okuma's APSU scale is a high accuracy glass scale that is mounted directly on the moving components of the machine. So it's a direct measuring system versus the encoder, which is mounted on the motor and acts as an indirect measuring system. The combination of this glass scale with the encoder gives us a direct absolute measuring system which ensures the highest accuracy that we can achieve. We have 48 pots in the tool magazine, so you're flexible with your tooling. Then we have a through spindle coolant supply system with 15 bar and 12 liter per minute. Also in standard, we equip the machine with a shower coolant system, so the machine can run many hours unmanned without cleaning the working range inside of the machine. And it is prepared for a lift-up chip conveyor, which simply needs to be plugged in and can run after that. Also, this machine is equipped in standard with ServoNavi. ServoNavi is again one of our intelligent technologies. And ServoNavi is a function where we have an automatic work weight setting. When we deliver the machine to the customer from our factory in Japan, the servo drive parameters are adjusted to the maximum workload. But this means that acceleration deceleration is quite low so that we can handle maximum workload. And with this function or the work rate setting, the machine can directly measure what is the actual weight on the table and adjust servo parameters to achieve an optimized acceleration deceleration. Also, we have a surface fine-tuning function to compensate reversal spikes on that machine and a vibration auto-adjustment. It's a very simple to use functionality. Again, from the home screen of the OSP suite, I can just switch to that functionality. Operator just needs to follow the instructions on the screen. For example, for auto work rate setting, he will just push this button. It then has to switch to MDI mode, execute this command, and after that, the machine will just move the axis with the workpiece with different speeds on a certain distance several times, calculate the maximum possible acceleration, deceleration, and modify the servo parameters. Same thing for reversal spike movement improvement. So if there is a reversal spike, whenever an axis is reversing visible on the workpiece, you execute this functionality. The controller will move the axis in circular and linear motions, will adjust the backslash and also the feed forward and torque control so that these reversal spikes will disappear and you will achieve a higher quality workpiece. Finally, if the axis drives produce some vibrations which are visible on the surface of the workpiece, we have our functionality to adjust the parameters against these different vibrations, and we are running the machine with different feed rates in different ranges. By that, we can again get some feedback from the measuring system of the machine, and by that fine-tune the servo system to achieve the best surface. All three functions are executed by a G-code, means, for example, for the auto work rate setting, we could put the G-code to the NC program. And if we have a workpiece where we are reducing the mass of the part dramatically during the cutting process, you could run it at the beginning of the cutting when you have a heavy block of material in the machine. And after removing the most of the chip removal, you could then execute it again and then optimize the parameters for the finishing process and get the shortest cutting time with the best result. Simultaneous 5-axis toolkit includes SuperNURBS, as explained, the functionality to improve the surface quality by recalculating from points to a spline and applying some tolerance control and feed forward control and acceleration deceleration control. After that, we have our tool center point control, which makes programming very easy because it is a functionality where the machine will compensate the linear motions when a rotary axis is tilting. So the tool is just following your rotary axis automatically and the CAM system doesn't need to take care of that. And you don't need to know the zero offset of the workpiece at the time you're working with your CAM system. Anchor tooltip manual feed rate is a functionality where we can place the tool on the workpiece, switch this function on, then rotate our rotary axis and the tool will follow this point even in the manual mode. This is very convenient for functions that use an attachment which is inclining the tool axis. So when the tool axis is not perpendicular to the machine axis anymore, it's quite difficult to move it out of the workpiece, but with this function, you're then moving directly in direction of the tool axis. Table origin coordinate system manual feed is a functionality where we can switch between inclined workpiece coordinate system and machine coordinate system. Slope machining function allows us to program the workpiece in the same dimensions as we see them on the drawing. We don't need to calculate any dimensions. For example, on this plane, I have my zero offset in the top. And then on the next plane, my zero offset is here and all dimensions are shown from this reference point. So I can shift my zero offset to a new position and then tell the machine by the slope machining function, incline this surface, if I like, also rotate it and incline it around the third axis and then program directly in this projection, same as all dimensions are shown on the drawing. That makes life very easy for the operators. Inverse time feed is a functionality that makes it easy to control the feed rate in 5-axis motion. This function will allow you to program the time for a certain movement versus the normal programming where we are programming a feed rate per minute. That means we have a control about the speed of the linear axis, but what happens between tool and workpiece when the axes are inclining is not 100% controllable by this. With the inverse time feed function, I can tell the machine, I want to have this movement on this distance in this fixed time, like 0.1 seconds. And by that, I can ensure a constant amount of material cutted by the cutting edge of the tool. The NCDT is a functionality which allows us to execute NC programs without downloading them to the controller directly from a server. So you could, for example, in this schedule file, tell the machine from where the ANSI program is coming, in which folder, and then tell the name. The schedule program will automatically execute all these files directly from a server computer, one after the other. And finally, tool posture command. This is a functionality to improve five-axis programs. CAD systems have tolerances, mathematical tolerances. So when you're designing a surface, for example, this mouse surface, you will already have some tolerance. Now you're outputting this data into a CAM system. And in the CAM system at the time of import for a step file, for example, also a tolerance is applied. With these tolerances adding on each other, it might happen that the curvature is not completely constant of some surfaces anymore. This means when we are projecting points for a tool and then calculating the vectors for the tool direction, this vector may not be smooth. It might have some directional small changes or some unevenness on these surfaces. With this functionality, we try to detect this unevenness and these direction changes and eliminate them. That means the machine will move very smooth and constant with high speed over the surface. Result will be a much reduced cutting time, up to, in some examples, even 50%. At the same time, improving the surface quality dramatically. The structure of the machine is shown on these pictures. You can see the base of the machine is a very rigid cast iron bed, which is supported by several feet directly to the ground. And the workpiece weight is carried by this strong bed construction and is transmitted directly into your foundation. Same counts for the five-axis construction. The trunnion table is running on the same guideways. These guideways are extremely wide, so that even if we are tilting the workpiece gravity center is never outside of the linear guides. The construction is a double column construction with a very heavy bed on top. With this trunnion here, we have a very solid base where we have a very short and very stable overhang for the X-axis slideway with a very short distance between the center of the spindle and the guideways for the X-axis. In this picture, you can see this distance here is very short because we have only 100 millimeter saddle for the X-axis that is moving. This gives us a very solid C construction where the gravity center of the workpiece is always supported on the base of the bed. And as I mentioned before already, even for the five-axis table, this base is wider than the table size and the maximum workpiece size, so that center of gravity is never leaving this construction. This is a very proven design. We have more than 10,000 sets of these machines already installed worldwide. The machine's basic weight is 8,300 kilograms, which is also expressing the rigidity of this machine. The machine has a very good, already mentioned hangover for the X and Y axis, very short hangover, therefore very rigid support. And we think it is the most stable or rigid double-sided support for the ANSI table in its class. The machine also is equipped with our thermo-friendly concept. And if you look to the machine, you will see the covers of the machine go down almost touching the floor. This is specially made or designed in that style so that no cold airflow from outside can influence the accuracy of the machine by touching the bed and cooling it down on one side, where it is still warm on the other side, which would make an incline of the bed, which will change the geometrical accuracy and makes it uncontrollable. So the design of this cover is one feature of the thermo-friendly concept. Also the symmetric design in the X-axis, and also the rib structure in our cast iron is designed so that if the temperature changes, the machine grows and shrinks parallel to the axis motion. We distribute several temperature sensors over the machine. We have the, in this case here, 8 temperature sensors, measuring the temperature distribution in the machine, for example, on the spindle bearings, on the ball screw bearings, and also in the bed as a reference temperature. With this model, we calculate a 3D model of the machine, and we can understand exactly the deflection by the thermal changes and compensate it in tens of microns increments continuously online the whole time when the machine is powered on. This ensures a very high accuracy, even if the environmental temperatures are fluctuating. In this graph, we show a temperature starting from 20 degrees, growing to 28 degrees over a time of 4 hours, then kept for 1 hour constantly on 28. And in the next 4 hours, the temperature is dropping back to 20 degrees. And then it stays constant for the next several hours. Here we measured the center of the spindle against the center of the table, means the tooltip against the workpiece, and we want to understand the displacement and keep this as small as possible. So here we got 8 micron, 5 micron, 6 micron. In all three axes, we keep the position between tool center and workpiece location within 10 micron accuracy and achieve a very high accuracy. The spindle is a very solid, rigid designed 15,000 RPM wide range spindle with 22 kilowatt and 199 newton meter torque. It has 5 bearings. The front 4 bearings are ceramic ball bearings with an inner diameter of 70 millimeter, which is very big for a 40 taper spindle. It is lubricated by oil mist lubrication, which makes it maintenance free. And we give a 3 years warranty, which is unlimited. Means if you buy an Okuma machine, you can start 15,000 RPM, run it constantly for 3 years without any interruption on 15,000 RPM, and we still warrant the spindle will be surviving. Here's the power and torque diagram of the spindle. From 50 RPM, we supply 199 newton meters. After 720 RPM, we have 15 kilowatt power. From 2000 to 4000 RPM, we increase the power from 15 to 22 kilowatt, and then we keep the power constant until 15,000 RPM. This spindle is very capable for all kinds of applications. You can use it with a 100 millimeter face mill for steel milling. You can use it with a big tapping tool, for example, M33. You can also use it with 15,000 RPM to mill some good quantity of material per minute with aluminium and other materials or small tools in high speed range. So this spindle will allow you to use this machine for any kind of application that you experience. Our linear axes are equipped with direct driven ball screws. There's no belt between the connection of the motor and the ball screw, which makes it very precise and direct. We have oversized high precision roller guides, which guarantee rigidity and long-term accuracy. We are using oversized high precision preloaded ball screws, which are also guaranteeing a high positioning accuracy. We achieve a positioning speed of 40 meters per minute in X and Y axis and 32 meters per minute in the Z axis. What we can achieve with this in combination with our upscale in X, Y and Z axis is a positioning accuracy of 1.4 micron in X, Y and Z axis and a repeatability of 0.9 micron millimeter in the X, Y and Z axis. Again, these values are actually measured values from a sample machine. The drive mechanism of our trunnion table is a hypoid gear. The hypoid gear has two big advantages. It can be adjusted absolutely play-free and it can, or backlash-free, and it can also be adjusted, it can run at high speeds because it has very low friction. So this drive mechanism makes possible that we are running C-axis with 50 and A-axis with 40 RPM per minute. We equip both rotary axes with our DD encoder, which is resolving 36 million increments per revolution. That allows us to achieve a positioning accuracy for rotary axis of 0.0055 degrees and a repeatability of 0.00013 degrees in both rotary axes. You can load a workpiece of a 600 millimeter diameter and 400 millimeter height to the work machine table, and up to 300 kilograms is the capacity of the machine. Compared to the outer dimension of the machine, this is a very big working range and allows a lot of flexibility in terms of workpieces that you can machine with this package machine. As a summary, we can say we offer a full package machine, which is easy to handle. There's no big discussions because all options are already in. It has a very attractive price, and we think we have the best price performance level in the market with our rigid and proven Okuma technology. Thank you very much. So far from my side.